Hello and thanks for tuning in to another episode of Cars and Caravan. And in today's vlog we're going to talk to you about a few products that we purchased just before Christmas that have finally arrived. I'm Dan and just off camera is my able assistant Tilly Biz. Say hello Tilly.
Hi.
And Tilly will just be passing me in the products as we talk about them. Now, over the last few months since purchasing our new Adria, a lot of you have been talking about towing covers, and it was something that I was interested in and went to check out. Now, we have purchased a towing cover, however, today's episode is not about the towing cover itself, because plenty of you have already made how to fit towing covers and given your reviews and opinions. But we have purchased one, and our towing cover, if I can have that please, Tilly, thank you, is from Tailored Covers, Specialised Covers, and it's the Tow Pro Plus, and we purchased that at the Caravan show earlier in the year, and it finally arrived. They had a really successful show, stepped up their game to meet all the orders before Christmas, so I'm really pleased that that's come through. Especially as we're going away this weekend and I want to fit this, as obviously the roads will be covered in quite a lot of muck and mess due to the winter. Now, that leads me on to the next bit. If I'm going to fit the towing cover, I wanted to make sure the front of the caravan was clean, because if I fit that without cleaning the front, the chances are any grit and grime on there from our last towing trip is just going to get scratched and embedded into the paintwork and the glass. So after reading a few reviews, thank you Tilly, I purchased the OLPRO Inside and Out 7-in-1 Cleaner. This will be the first time that I've used it in today's vlog. They reckon it's good for caravan exteriors, black streaks, glass, wheels, bathrooms, hard surfaces and fabrics. Now, with the black streaks, we have got a few on the front of our caravan, although they're not too bad being a new caravan. So I'm going to use this diluted today. However, they do say if you've got really stubborn black streaks and marks, use it neat, sparingly but neat, and it should really help with that. But we'll look at that in a minute when we test it out with the next bit of equipment that we're here to talk about. And that is this little beauty. It is the WORX Hydroshot. Now, like many of you, my caravan isn't at home on my drive and it's in storage, and although I have got access to electricity and water, it's not conveniently located without having maybe 50 to 100 meters of electricity cable and a huge length of hose. So I was looking for something portable and lightweight that I could take with me to clean the caravan, and this came up in a few searches, and so I thought we would take a look. Now, they don't class this as a pressure washer, but it's somewhere in between having a standard hose and a full-on pressure washer kit. But what we'll do is we'll take a look inside the box, show you what's included in the price, and then a bit later on we'll put it to the test on the front of the caravan and see how it performs. Okay, so let's have a look inside the WORX Hydroshot and see what you get included in the box for your money. As you can already see on the front, recommended use is for caravan, tents, bikes, boats, watering the garden, cleaning windows. There is a host of accessories that you can buy for this bit of kit, but in this pack, as you can see, we have the instructions for the handheld portion itself, for the battery and charger, and then there's a little bit about the power share, and I'll just I'll mention that when we get onto that section. There's the main wand itself, and that's the bit that has the pressurized section in it for producing the water spray. A cleaning brush, which should come in handy, and then underneath this bit of packaging we have the hose that supplies the water. Now, they say that you can take the water from any fresh water supply, so stream, puddle, river, lake, even a 2 litre water bottle. Now, if you do something like a 2 litre water bottle, which you might take if you wanted to use this for cleaning off your muddy boots or a bike or something like that before you travel again, is you can actually remove this hose attachment at the end here, and there is a second attachment that you can buy that is specifically designed so you can screw on the 2 litre bottles and then just have a ready water supply with you.
However, for today, for cleaning the Caravan, we're going to be using the hose and the nozzle that's already on it. And we've actually filled up our 40 litre Aquarol and brought it with us to the Caravan. There's a float on there to stop it from going under, and there's your small filter on the end there to stop any muck if you're drawing water from a puddle or a lake or a river. Next in the bag there, there's a little portable bucket if you need it. So if you want to grab a water supply and put it in there. To be honest, I don't know how much water it actually holds or whether it'd be enough to clean anything substantial. Probably, again, only designed for maybe. In the advert, they showed like washing down your dog or a bike, your boots or something like that. Maybe good for that. We have the jet nozzle there, and that, as you can see, has five different styles on there depending on what it is you're cleaning or what you want it to do. We have the little soap bottle, and today we're going to be using this, and that's where we're going to put the 7-in-1, the inside and out. Going to put a small dosage in there and see how that foams up the front of the Caravan for us for cleaning. And then there's an extra long wand there if you need for higher reach. You can add that and then put back in your smaller nozzle there. And then last but not least, in this little bit here of accessories, it's just a small bag to pack away everything in. And it's a net bag, just so if it's still wet, it'll drip dry. And then in this box here, we have the power supply, and I have already opened and charged this. But there's your 20 volt battery, which is a power share battery. Now, the nice thing with the power share batteries, and this goes back to the leaflet here, is the power share battery can actually be used on a multiple of products that WORX make. Everything from hedge trimmers to leaf blowers to lawn mowers. And so you could just have one or two batteries and share them over multiple products. So in the future, when I'm looking for new power tools, I might check that out and actually see how good that is to have that battery sharing. But the other thing you can do is, this is 20 volts, but they do a 40 volt version if you want a slightly bigger battery. And just a very neat compact charger in there for the system. As I say, I already put that on charge ready for today's vlog. It was new out of the box, took about 4 hours to charge, but I believe it'd be quicker than that recharging from after use, as it will probably have some residual battery in it. So anyway, that's the kit. We're going to go and try and bundle it all back together, take it outside, have a look, see how it performs on washing the front of our Adria. Okay, so here we are outside the Caravan, and just before I show you the front and the dirt, here is a really nice little touch. It's Have a Safe Journey checklist that Stuart Longton put in the front of WORX Caravans. Great idea, really handy for first times like ourselves. Gives us a little point of reference we can look as we're just going around the Caravan, making sure everything is ready before we set off on our travels. Anyway, here we go. Here's the black streaks on the front of the Caravan. These are the things we want to remove, along with the general dirt, debris and grease and muck that is on there from our last travels, before we fit the OLPRO Plus. And as you would expect, plenty of black marks underneath the Caravan windows. And as I'm sure all of you get as well, right over in the far corner, we've got some debris and leaves, and some of the green mildew there in the far corner. So we've brought the kit outside with us, and at the moment, just to make you aware, we're still filming on the iPhone 10. In a minute we're going to change over to the GoPro, so the quality of sound may change. But out with us, we've brought the hose. Nice little bit that I missed last time is there is an attachment on there to hold it onto an edge of a bucket. We have the actual main handle itself, the little soap bottle that we're going to put the OLPRO 7-in-1 inside and out in. There's the bucket, I'm going to show you that in a second. And there's the brush. But here's the bucket, I can't do it one-handed, so if my able assistant Tilly come in, she's just going to untwist it, show you, give you a rough idea on the size. There we go. And obviously you need the water to hold it up and hold it open. Okay, you can put that down, Tilly. Thank you. But that is there, and that comes with the kit. And as I say, today we're just using the 40 litre Aquarol for our water supply along with the hose. Okay, so I'm just going to put a bit of the 7-in-1 in. I'm just going to probably go up to the first line on this attempt. I think that'll do. See how we get on. So just to show it's not too heavy and quite versatile, Tilly here is giving the caravan a little bit of a spray down and me by the looks of it. Okay, so I'm just going to show you the different jets of water. So we have just a straightforward shower spray, you can see that, and then there's a finer mist on there, which is 40 degrees. There's a 25 degrees mist and a 15 degrees mist, and a zero, which is a quite powerful one, really good for getting into all the nooks and crannies and getting any of the dirt out down the edges, etc. So here we are back at the journey checklist, and just for those, because I know it's been another hot topic of conversation, check and talk the wheel nuts. So for all of you that are on Twitter and joined in the conversation, there we go, top of the list. Anyway, so for a point of reference, there's the journey checklist. If we have a look to the side of the caravan, as you can see, all the black streaks have gone and it looks quite smart. And then along underneath the window, and again, some really good results with the removal of the black marks. And even if we go round to the other side, this was where the green was, and that has also gone. So yeah, good impressions for the first time out. Little bit to learn, but let's head on back into the caravan and have a talk about the kit.
Okay, so we're back inside the caravan. I've packed away the hydro shot, which is nice and simple as you can expect. But this is just sort of a brief summary of how we got on with it. So the actual gun itself is fairly lightweight, nice and easy to use. Even Tilly managed to handle that all right, didn't you, Tilly?
Yeah.
With the spray. And obviously the battery pack, easily removable and chargeable. As for all the accessories, great to have all of those in the box. I'm not convinced that that net bag is going to last long. It's not overly heavy duty, and with all the bits and pieces poking and sticking out, I think they're soon going to get a hole in that. So that would be a nice upgrade if they were to do something a bit more substantial for holding all of the accessories. And in fact, there you go, as I'm holding it already, the actual little bungee cord grip has ripped away from the top of the bag, so already that's obsolete. So I'll probably look for my own storage solution for that. Although on the whole it worked really well, we did notice towards the end, and it was after we shot a bit of video, although I will have a look in the edit just in case I caught some of it, there seemed to be a little bit of a problem with the water supply. Now whether that was due to the hose not getting a good feed of water, I'm not sure, but I thought that's what the float on the end of the hose was for, was to keep the hose in the water at all times in the right direction so you didn't get any airlocks. But we had a little bit of loss of pressure every now and then. I suppose it could be the battery, but like I say, that had a good 4 hour charge plus, because I left it on charge even after it said it was fully charged. So I will take it home and charge it again. But we did manage to get the front of the Caravan done before those little niggles came in. So I will have a look in again next time I use it to see, just in case it was something that I was doing wrong, obviously on its first outing. But when the water pressure was there, it was really good, especially on the different sprays. We're able to get into all the nooks and crannies. The brush worked well, it was nice and soft. I did test it first on a not so obvious part of the Caravan to make sure it wasn't going to scratch. Thumbs up for that, that worked well. I didn't like the angle of the brush on the arm, and especially on the extension arm, it was too flimsy and flexible. But when you had it on the short arm, again, the angle was a little bit weird trying to get on the curves of the Caravan, but nice up close, it really worked well and helped us to get rid of the black streaks. And obviously, big thumbs up to the OLPRO 7-in-1 cleaner. In the little foam bottle, we got a good, nice foam across the front of the Caravan, and it helped lift them black marks off really, really well. So that brilliant. And we look forward to trying that on other parts of the Caravan when we do a more rigorous clean, a deeper clean. And obviously, being a family Caravan, be interesting to see how it coats on the upholstery if we get any little spills or marks and that. But for now, that is the Hydroshot WORX Hydroshot. And quite impressed. Really good for remote cleaning. Just having that water in the aqua roll and using that. Really pleased. Probably get myself another battery, because this is a big old Caravan. And I would imagine that the battery might not last for me to do the sides and the roof and everything else. So, but otherwise, really good. And Tilly is going to do the last bit. But if you have any questions about this, how I got on, etc., that not in the video, then please do just drop a comment below. And Tilly, over to you to do the last bit.
Subscribe to my dad's channel and comment below, because I think that he's really good, and hopefully you'll do it to my channel as well, just like I said in the last video. But
hang on, what is your channel, because you haven't name dropped it once yet this video.
My channel's called Tilly Biz. If you watch it, I'm giving you a great thumbs up. Sorry if you don't like them too much, it's difficult. We're a brand new channel. Cars and Caravans only started like a couple of weeks ago. Yep. Chili Biz probably started like 1 year ago or something.
Something like that. But yeah, so have a look. We would appreciate any subscriptions, likes. If you dislike the video, that's fair enough. We're learning. We hope to keep getting better. But that's our review of the WORX Hydroshot. Thanks for watching Cars and Caravan. We'll see you in the next vlog.
Bye.
Yep.